Episode 2054, Less is More.
Moms, needing a little inspiration and a ray of hope? You've come to the right place. This is the show that you can turn to for just the pick-me-up you need. This is Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by.
Happy, happy day. It is a brand new day, and that means you have the opportunity to impact the world that you touch. It's Inspiration Motivation Day. Come on, you got this. Less is more. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, how much are you trying to cram in your day? Quality over quantity leads to higher satisfaction and greater success. Nail your everyday. Less is more. Now, I know there are arguments that support either side of less is more or more is less. And we can chat about this till both of us are blue in the face. However, today, I want you to consider a quote by Ernest Hemingway. It reads this: if a writer knows enough about what he is writing about, he may omit things that he knows. The dignity of movement of an iceberg is due to only 1/9 of it being above water. You're like, wait a minute, how does this apply to me? I'm not an iceberg, I'm not floating in water, and I'm not a novelist. I didn't win a Nobel Prize in literature, so why are we talking about this? Because today, this iceberg is going to be your inspiration. Now, I know this is not your everyday read, right? But this quote struck me in the gut. It caught me truly off guard. And it was one of those moments where I sat there and thought, oh my gosh, this so proves that less is more. We are trying to pile on so much in our everyday that we miss what really matters. I found this from Hemingway's biographer, Carlos Baker. And he believed that as a writer of short stories, Hemingway learned, quote, how to get the most from the least, how to prune language and avoid waste motion, how to multiply intensities, and how to tell nothing but the truth in a way that allowed for telling more than the truth. And Baker went on to say that this sort of writing style that Hemingway used was noted as the iceberg theory. And this iceberg theory suggests that a story's narrative and nuanced complexities, complete with symbolism, operate under the surface of the story itself. Less is more. You know, I experienced just what Hemingway has described in his writings regarding the iceberg theory. You know, we went on a trip this past weekend to celebrate my mother-in-law's 75th birthday. And if you were to calculate the time we spent together in that 48 hours, believe it or not, it added up to just over the 1/9 mark. Now, when I saw this quote, this was after we had left and we came back. And it struck me because I thought to myself, before we went on the trip, do we really want to do this? Do you know how much money we're paying because it was short notice? We hadn't planned this out like months and months and months in advance. It was last minute. My father-in-law kind of pressed us on it and said, we would really like you to come. We think it is very important for lots of different reasons. And so my husband and I talked, we went back and forth and we're like, well, we could go, but the kids will have just started school. There's no way we can pull them out. And plus, to take all of us, well, it would really break the bank account. And so we paused for just a moment. We said, okay, let's think this through here. We could go, and in less than 48 hours, we're going to be right back where we started. And yeah, we're not going to have as much time, but we will have gone. Or we could look at it and plan and wait for a 4 or 5 day trip instead. We went back and forth, but the question remains, would we have received the same benefit doing the 4 or 5 day versus doing what we did in the 48 hours, or would it have actually been less than 1/9 mark? Well, we won't know because, well, we didn't do that. We opted for the shorter, more concise trip. And already we have seen the impact, the iceberg theory. The whole idea that we may not have spent 4 or 5 days together, but in that very short amount of time, less than 10 hours of concentrated time and a very close knit, because there wasn't anything open. We did all the cooking at home. We didn't go out. We didn't sightsee. It was all about family. It was all about talking. We were together. And I would care to bet, now we'll never know, of course, that if we would have gone for the 4 or 5 day, we may not have actually spent that much quality time together. We may have been together more, but maybe we would have gone sightseeing, or we've gone for a hike, or maybe a movie or something like that, if things were different and we had more time. But really, would we have spent actually more time? I don't think so. Hemingway's iceberg theory. We didn't spend a lot of time together, right? When you just look at the tip, it was very, very little. But if you look underneath the surface, oh my gosh, the impact is great. In your everyday, are you focusing on more is better? Or are you choosing a less popular approach where less is more? And I want you to look at your everyday, your spouse, your children, your career, business, your school, your activities, your involvement in the community, in your church. All of this that fills your calendar, that fills your hours in your day. Is it all about, I got to keep piling on more? Yes, 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 yes. Or is it, no, wait, no, not today. Can't do this. Oh, yes, I can do this. You are creating a greater impact with the story when less is more. It's all about the little things. So where do you need to slow down and unload a few items on your calendar? Where do you need to say no so you can say yes to your family or your marriage? Less is more. I really want you to chew on this quote a little bit. I want you to think about that iceberg theory and how that applies to your life. Do you need to look at more quality instead of quantity? You know, when I was running a day school, it broke my heart because the parents would come and drop their children off and their waking hours were spent more with me than they were with their parents. Yet, I know their parents were doing the best that they could and they enjoyed what they did with their job. They got satisfaction out of it. However, they also got satisfaction spending time with their child. Now, if I go back, which I have seen some of those day school children that I cared for, were they greatly impacted because mom and dad were not there every single second of their waking life? No. If I asked mom and dad, could they have changed it? Would they? Sometimes they would answer yes, and other times they would tell me no. Because you see, in the moment, it was what they needed to do for their family to provide a lifestyle for what they wanted to create. It wasn't about right or wrong. But when they were together as a family, it was quality, not just about quantity. That 1/9, the tip of the iceberg, created a great impact as the life continued and their journey continued as a family. Less is more. Be an Ernest Hemingway in your own life. It's the kisses, the keep it simple strategy, everyday solutions. And go out and create your now. Be present. Be incredible. Be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.